folks, and welcome back to twitch.tv/gameswithnick. Today is Wednesday, which means we are playing through Broken Sword. Tell me, maybe. Put in pause. So quick summary. We almost died in a, essentially terrorism attack. A bomb exploded in a cafe in downtown Paris. We've been trying to discover who was responsible for that and why, for honestly no good reason. We kind of fell the call of adventure. We've met with this journalist called Nico Collar, and she's been really helping us make sense of things. And we're currently in Ireland trying to find the details on an excavation that a certain doctor... name I can't remember. I feel like it's Pegasus or Perseus or something like that. But the goal of getting a gem and a tripod and sort of finding information about why this Pegrim, there we go, but Dr. Pegrim, how he was involved in this whole thing. So, back. And as you can see, there's the goat. The goat is sort of the,
It was a rusted piece of iron. Maybe part of a plow or something.
One of the mascots of the Broken Sword series. There was always goats involved in things.
The rope by which the goat was tethered had become tangled on the old plowshare.
And we took care of the goat like a pro.
As I dipped my fingers into the soft white powder, I realized what it was. Plaster of Paris. I'd used it in kindergarten to make casts of animal paw prints.
Okay.
I reached into the sack, but it was empty. The statue was too heavy to lift. It overbalanced into the sand. As I swung the stone upright, I noticed it had left a pattern of holes in the sand.
And I bet that that's exactly the pattern of holes that matches this thing.
I placed my fingers and thumb into the holes in the wall. Nothing happened.
Can I grab that?
I reached into the sack.
No. I need to put it into something.
It was a handful of plaster left.
Oh,
the castle.
I already grabbed the plaster, that's why. And this. Put the plaster in.
I sprinkled the plaster on the sand until the holes were filled.
Now, I'm sure you remember, but last time we drenched the beer towel. And that's why we did that.
The trickle of water was quickly absorbed by the plaster. I eased the solid piece of plaster from the sand. Underneath, it had formed a perfect copy of the statue.
Sweet. Now we can use this perfect copy. This thing.
The hardened plaster cast fitted snugly into the 5 matching sockets. There was a soft thud, then silence.
Okay. Evening, Paris. What are we up to? Honestly, not much.
Another coded message using the same cipher system. So, Plantard was involved with Cachon. Plantard. Pierre killed. Murderer must have followed trail from Arno and Yamada. He will come for us now. We must be vigilant. Thierry's girl broke into Pierre's safe. She worries me. Imelda. So much for Imelda's innocence. Plantard was working for her and for Cachon. But why did Plantard want to meet? Was it a trap? Or maybe he was in too deep and needed me to tell a story, whatever the story was. One thing was clear. It was a story worth killing for.
So, a quick summary on what happened to her. So, Nico Collar is a journalist who was scheduled to interview this guy that's candidate for French presidency or whatnot. And he got killed by the same killer that blew the cafe where George Stobbart was sitting. So that's what led us to the George Stobbart to get involved in it. Turns out that her father, who died when she was young, might have been involved with these people. And we're trying to kind of figure out what's been up.
I had messages waiting to be played.
You have 3 messages.
Hey, Collard, it's me, your favorite editor. Guess what? I'm gonna give you a second chance. I need somebody to write the TV column. Pays lousy, so what's new? If you're interested, drop by the office. In fact, drop by the office anyway. We have to talk, Nico. That story of yours I spiked. It won't go away. You've made some dangerous enemies out there.
Merlin's the killer. I better get over there and mourn her now. When it came to being two-faced, Imelda was up there with the best. I owed her nothing, but I couldn't just let her die. I arrived to find the Palais Royal courtyard deserted. I only hoped that I'd beaten the assassin here. I had to warn Imelda before it was too late.
Can I already climb this, or do you want to meet Fred or first? Right.
Presumably to stop critics stealing it. Who else would want to?
Okay, gotta try the door first. Hey, what? Toot?
No way was I going to break through a
door. Yeah, nice, thanks for stopping by.
The intercom system wasn't working. Bad sign. Somebody had cut the wire.
Yeah, also, you know, I've played this game a lot of times on Game Boy Advance, of all places, because that's the version I had. So all of these bits from the director's cut are kind of new to me, and I don't really remember them.
By wires. Maybe it wasn't art after all. Maybe it was a cell phone transmitter. People say, what's the point of modern art? I say, isn't it obvious?
You do now.
Just your average modern art retaining wire.
How can we break that wire?
Cachon's front door. There was a fresh scratch on the paint. The kind that's left when someone's picked the lock. If I was right, Imelda was getting a lesson from a mime artist, and it wasn't the old moving staircase routine.
And I picked the lock?
A hair clip to pick a high security lock? Might work in a movie, but not for me.
Yeah, I figured as much. What else do we... Oh, I can really just unhook them.
I unhooked the first wire.
No need to actually use it. If you're not familiar with the,
both wires removed, the statue remained upright.
If you're not familiar with the director's cut version, we just finished Ireland with George.
If I could deconstruct this, I could deconstruct anything.
Alright, let's go in. Though I'm sure it will be too late.
The sheet was thick and strong. I'd need more than my hands to tear it. No. The window had been repaired with industrial plastic sheeting.
Back down.
I got this far, I wasn't kidding.
Okay. So we're not going back down. Ooh, elephant.
No.
Nope. Cylinder?
No.
Key?
No.
Running out of options here.
No.
Nope.
No.
What in God's name am I supposed to be doing? Bullet? Oh. Bullet casing apparently does the job. Why does it do the job?
The showcase had been flattened at one end, forming a serrated edge.
Oh, I guess it's a serrated edge. Weird.
My God.
And she's dead. I am shocked.
Imelda. Oh no. Nico? Don't worry, you're going to be all right.
You know that isn't true.
It was Merlin, wasn't it?
Dressed as a cavalier. Absurd. You came to warn me, didn't you?
I must be crazy.
Let me see you, Nico.
All this time you were just using me. Which one is the real Imelda?
You are an extraordinary girl. Thierry would have been so proud of you.
You didn't know my father.
So like him. Something about the eyes. I wish we'd had time to get to know each other.
She was gone. She cheated me, lied to me, used me. But why?
Hey, my mom. That was happening here.
Imelda looked the same. Beautiful, inscrutable. The ice queen alone in her ice palace. I opened it. Inside was a tiny gold key. I took the key. I had to leave. I knew I could never return.
Oh no, I know what I need to use. Key on. Get up. Get up. Get up.
In the dim light, I caught the reflection of something metallic. A small, sinister-looking metal disc had been tucked under my father's box. It was a bug, Oh, chère cousine. You left me a little present. You shouldn't have.
The reason why she mentioned her cousin is that somebody came in our apartment pretending to be her cousin.
Don't scare me.
Just a little bit of context there if you missed the previous part of the playthrough.
The box was carved by my father. It never had a key. The elephant on the lid was a perfect match to Cochon's.
No, it clearly had a key, and the key was carried by Imelda. She's still my mom.
I couldn't believe it. Imelda's key opened my father's box. I dreaded what I was going to find inside.
Oh, she was still my mom.
It was a photograph of Imelda, but why here? In my father's box. I felt as if a black hole had swallowed me up. Imelda and Canchon grinning. While behind them, a village was being razed to the ground, its people butchered. And there, next to them, staring out at me across the years, my own father. There was a letter. I feared there was even worse to come.
Tell my mom.
Hotel Saint Georges, Algiers, Friday. My darling Thierry. By the time you read this, you'll be safely out of Africa. You need not fear. Pierre and the organization do not know who you are really working for, or about us. Did you think I would betray you? I could not. You wanted me to leave him, but I don't have your courage. I know too much of what has been going on here. They would find me and they would kill us both. Enjoy your life in Paris, Thierry. Your life of honor, of patriotic duty. Do they give medals to spies? No. They'll just give you a funny job in an embassy somewhere. I could never share that with you. Imagine me, a diplomat's wife. So I must stay here with Pierre, the two of us bound together by what we have done to this country. Au revoir, my love. You will be in my heart until I die. Imelda. Suddenly everything made sense. My father had been working undercover for the government. He was one of the good guys after all. He and Imelda must have fallen in love. She'd found out who he really was, so he had to leave. It had broken her heart, but she had never revealed it to anyone. I knew I couldn't either. Whatever he was doing, he'd had good reason to keep it secret. I decided I would respect that and tell nobody.
Okay, so maybe she was not my mom. She was just in love with my dad. Which, hey, you know, better. Next morning.
I knew it was George. For a moment, I was tempted to pretend that I was out, or ask him to go away and come back later. But then... Come in.
Hello, George. So, where did you stay last night?
At McDevitt's. I got to drinking with Doyle and a couple of the guys.
That explains why you look so ill today. Did you get any sleep at all?
Not much. I had to share the room with another guy.
Did he snow?
Hardly. He was dead.
And you say P. Graham has disappeared?
Without a trace. But my visit wasn't a complete waste of time.
P. Graham's gem?
The Templar's gem. Whoever Jacques Marquet is, he's in for a disappointment.
Jacques Marquet?
He's the guy who should have collected the gem from Fitzgerald.
What are your plans?
I want to find out who, what, or where Montfaucon was. All I've got to go by is the name and a picture of a hanged man. Do you want to look after the gem?
No, Georges. I'd be too tempted to sell it.
Because you know fences?
Maybe not. That is not a good idea. No. Look, Nico, a handful of plaster.
Yeah. Why is it that men never really grow up?
What's your problem, sister?
Your pockets stuffed with useless junk like little boys.
You never know when useless junk might
be. So true. Okay, well, I guess that's it.
I can't sit here all day, much as I'd like to.
Okay. Don't forget to look for Lobino at the Kron Museum. And why don't you see if Rosso has heard anything?
Okay. Anything else I can do for you while I'm out? Shopping, a trip to the laundromat?
Just take care of yourself.
I so much wanted to talk to George about everything that had happened, but I knew I never could. My father's connection to Africa would have to remain a secret forever. His bravery would be known only to the government and to me. Revealing it would just damage his memory. People would take the story and twist it. Before long, he would be the villain and Carchon would be the hero. I know how they do that. I'm a journalist.
Okay, I wonder if that's the end of the, Sorry, didn't mean to come back. I thought this was the police station.
Come in.
I wonder if this is the end of the director's cut material.
What are you?
I want all I've got.
Yeah, no, sorry.
Okay, and
okay.
Bye. Thank you. All right, post the police.
Sergeant Moo?
Yes.
I was one of the last people to see the victim alive, Sergeant.
Does that worry you?
Yes, it does. I feel I kinda... I owe it to him to find his killer.
That is best left to the authorities, monsieur. Did he speak to you? Tell you anything?
No, he just grinned and nodded.
Don't let it trouble you, monsieur. Go home and try to forget.
I know the identity of the dead guy. His name was Plantau.
Is that so? You knew him, did you?
No, but...
We'll know everything there is to know about him soon enough.
I'm trying to be helpful here.
The best way you can help us is to go home, monsieur.
I'd like to report an assault.
Yes, monsieur? Where is the victim?
I'm the victim. I've been harassed by a pair of thugs.
I see. And where did this alleged assault take place?
Outside the Hotel Ubu. They stopped me as I was leaving and went through my pockets.
Could you describe the suspects, monsieur?
One looked like a gorilla, and the other looked like a weasel. Their names are Flap and Guido.
Boom. I'll get them this time.
Have you heard of a man called Marquet?
Yes. He used to be known as the Mole of Montmartre. I heard he's been hospitalized, probably by one of his rivals.
Which hospital was Marquet taken to?
The Hagenmeyer Clinic, in the Avenue des Hérissons.
Okay.
Why was Marquet known as the Mole of Montmartre?
Because he lived in Montmartre, I suppose.
Yeah, but why the Mole?
I don't know. Maybe he ruined people's lawns.
Do you know a man named Khan? He's a shifty-looking guy with a scar on his left cheek.
No, monsieur.
He also calls himself Thomas Merlin.
I'm sorry, Monsieur Stobart. I don't know him. Has this man any connection with the bombing of the cafe?
Yes. I believe Khan was the name he used when he hired the clown costume. Do you recognize the man in this photograph?
No, monsieur.
It's the guy who bombed the cafe. The clown.
This man looks nothing like a clown?
He's taken off his grease paint and costume.
Then there is nothing to link this man with the killing.
Nothing? Look at those murderous eyes.
Hardly likely to get him convicted.
See you later, Sergeant.
I don't think he can talk to Rosso, I guess. Well, I guess Russ is not there, is he? We did get the hospital.
There was no sign of the crew.
Hi, my name's George Stobart.
Really? If you wish to make an appointment, see the receptionist.
I'm looking for a guy named Jacques Marquet.
In which department does he work?
He doesn't. He's a patient.
I see. You do realize there are strict policies regarding visiting hours, don't you?
This is important. I have to talk to Marquet urgently.
We make no exceptions to the rules.
It's a matter of life and death.
The well-oiled running of this hospital is a matter of life and death. That's why we have rules.
I think I ought to warn you that Marquet is not what he seems.
Explain yourself.
He's in league with a bunch of guys who want to take over the world.
Nonsense. Besides, Marquet's employers have paid in advance for one of our most exclusive private rooms.
Could you tell me who Marquet's employers are?
Certainly not.
Do you recognize the man in this photograph?
No, sir. I do not.
All right.
May I have the honor of shaking you by the hand?
You may not. I don't encourage physical contact between my staff.
I love that they always find a reason for people not to shake my hand.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir?
Is this the Hagenmeyer Clinic?
That's correct.
I thought I was in a garden center.
Oh, the plans. They were my idea. A little greenery to evoke the spirit of nature. How may I help you?
I'm here to see Jacques Marquet.
Oh, yes. Are you related to our client, sir?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm his long-lost brother.
A brother half his age with a different name and an American accent.
Yeah, people always say that. I blame Mom. We were separated at an early age. After a mix-up in the nursery at the Oakland shopping mall.
I've never heard anything so ridiculous in all my life.
I guess not.
That is pretty ridiculous.
Has Marquet been visited by a man in a clown costume?
Oh, no.
You haven't seen a man in disguise?
Well, there's Theodore the Bear. He comes every Thursday to entertain the children. Personally, I think he scares them half to death in that crummy old bear suit. If I was stuck on my back with tubes in every orifice, he's the last person I'd want to see.
Has Marquet had a visit from a pair of gangsters?
I should hope not. Can you describe them?
A thin guy who looks like a weasel and his friend, the gorilla.
Sounds as if they escaped from a zoo.
So, do I get to see Marquet before the funeral?
That attitude will get you nowhere. My instructions were quite clear. No one gets to see Marquet. So unless you can prove you're a relative or a close acquaintance, you're wasting your time here.
Have you seen this man?
Clinic?
No, sir. And I never forget a face.
Okay, well, look out for this guy, because, he's a bad guy.
Look at this ID pass.
So you're Merlin. Marquet's been asking for you.
Oh.
For me?
Lucky break.
He was shouting your name when they brought him in here. Now, let me see.
Let's ignore that. Just introduce myself as George Stobart to this man.
Oh, he's being transferred.
This man 2 feet away, but...
He's on Ward J2. That's... Nurse Grendel's ward.
What's so bad about Nurse Grendel?
She runs that ward like a South American prison.
Keeping a well-disciplined ward isn't a crime, is it?
Well-disciplined. In the discipline and punishment stakes, she'd whip the butt off the Marquis de Sade. Everything, I mean everything, is done to a strict routine. 6 o'clock, alarm call. 6:10, bowel movements, and woe betide anyone who doesn't have a result. Those patients of hers are like Pavlova's dogs.
She sounds like a real nightmare.
And then some.
If Nurse Grendel is that bad, how come the authorities tolerate her?
She's like part of the furniture.
I was beginning to get the picture. This woman was jealous, with a big green capital J. How do I find Nurse Grendel's ward?
Down the corridor on the left, turn right at the senior consultant's washroom. Right again at the executive coffee lounge. Bear left past the administrator's sauna. And turn left at the end. That's J2. And good luck.
This is a fucking giant hospital.
Thanks for your help, ma'am.
You're welcome.
As I turned the corner, I saw the source of the hellish noise which echoed through the corridors. It was an industrial polishing machine with an odd-looking guy in tow.
Oui, monsieur.
Is this ward J2?
It is, but you're not supposed to be here. We have strict rules about visiting hours.
Can't you make an exception? I've come all the way from California.
You must speak to the doctor.
I can't wait that long. What if he snuffs it?
You can't talk like that here. This is a hospital. You will have to leave.
The connector in the socket supplied electricity to the polishing machine. Hello.
What's that?
I said, hello.
Oh, hiya.
I'd like to talk to you for a minute.
That's what I thought you said. Don't look so down in the mouth. No matter how bad things seem, I never let life get on top of me.
Oh, yeah? What's your secret?
Why, it's easy. All you have to do is smile and whistle this little tune.
You know what? If you start whistling, I'll bust you in the teeth.
I'm not sure why...
It's a deal.
Somebody has a British accent in the middle of Paris, where they seem to be working, but...
What's the problem with Nurse Grendel?
She's uptight and twisted on account of a broken heart.
Oh, that's too bad. I thought she was just plain bad-tempered.
That also. By the way, sir, I wouldn't stand too close to Mr. Shiny's grease valve. If he has an emission, it'll take the shine clean off your shoes. Say... Nice sneakers.
Thanks. Have you seen any unsavory characters lurking about in the corridors?
No, sir, I haven't. But I've got nothing to worry about. What's that, Mr. Shiny? You'd take good care of the rascals, I'll bet you would. With a friend like him, I've no fear of oppressors.
It must be a great comfort.
He is.
Would Mr. Shiny be your polishing machine by any chance?
Please, don't call him that. He's more of a friend than a machine. I've had Mr. Shiny for 3 years, and he's never let me down once.
How come you got so attached to a polishing machine?
I asked you not to call him that. He's got a name, you know.
Yeah, Mr. Shiny. It's just that...
You think it's odd, don't you? I don't mind. The rest of the staff think I'm twisted. I heard them snorking behind me back when I gave Mr. Shiny his weekly pull through.
Do you know where I'd find a patient called Marquet?
No, I'm not allowed on the wards with Mr. Shiny.
Take a look at this red nose.
Are you a policeman?
No, this is a clown's nose, not a policeman's.
Are you a clown?
Do you recognize this matchbook?
You should never, ever play with matches.
I know that, but...
People get hurt when they do. They end up in hospital, like the burger lady. She was so burned up, they didn't know whether to use bandages or onions.
Do you recognize the man in this photograph?
Who is it?
That's what I'm asking you. Have you seen him before?
How should I know? You haven't told me who he is.
Take a look at the photo.
Yeah, okay.
Now, have you seen him before?
No.
Do you recognize this pass?
No, I don't. Should I?
No, but I wondered if you'd seen a stranger flashing it about.
No, sir. But if I had, Mr. Shiny would take care of him.
See you later.
Yeah, take care now. Hey now, you can't go in there.
How come?
I'm responsible for the contents of that cupboard.
Cupboard.
As I tugged the plug out of the socket, the polishing machine coughed, spluttered, and died.
Mr. Shiny, what's wrong, pal?
What are you doing? Why are you not taking advantage of this occasion? Alright, my name is Dr. Stalbert. I'm a new physician in charge.
Good afternoon, Doctor. The patients are ready for your inspection, Doctor.
Thank you, nurse.
You'll need this, Doctor.
She gave me a long, narrow metal box and a stunning smile. Thanks.
Could you take a look at the client in bed number 3 now? His name is Eric Sopmarsch.
Do you have a patient named Marquet on this ward?
Oui, monsieur. He is in the private room at the end of the ward. He has been placed in strict isolation.
Do you have any clowns on the ward?
Why, yes, we do. A professional clown.
I'll bet he lightens the place up.
Hardly. Monsieur Boissy has been in a coma for the last 3 months.
What's wrong with Boissy?
He was involved in a very nasty accident. A silly stunt involving a unicycle. His current condition is due to post-traumatic shock. It's unlikely he'll ever perform as a clown again.
Damn.
Ill wind that blows nobody any good. Why is Marquet in quarantine?
If you wish to know more, you'll have to speak to Herr Hagenmeier. All I know is that Marquet's room is strictly out of bounds.
Do you know who paid for Marquet's room?
No, of course I don't.
Preferential treatment like that must cost an arm and a leg.
That's not my concern, monsieur.
Do you recognize the man in this photograph?
No, I don't.
Do you recognize the...
No.
Thank you, nurse.
Au revoir.
Hello, anybody home?
Who are you?
My name is Dr. Stobart, and I'm here to steer you down the rocky road to recovery.
Dr. Monroe said there was no cure for what I've got.
Your problem is you stayed in bed too long.
Are you sure you're a qualified doctor?
You better believe it. I'm going to take your blood pressure.
Why?
I'm a doctor. It's my job. Seems fine to me.
You're not doing it right.
What can you tell me about Marquet?
He's the man in the private room, isn't he? That room was mine before I was tossed out like a common squatter.
A common squatter, you say?
Do you know what's wrong with Marquet?
They won't even say what's wrong with me. Tell me, Doctor, what's your opinion?
It's too early to say.
But I've been here for 3 months.
What's your impression of Nurse Grendel?
She's a very efficient young woman.
Efficient? You make her sound like a vacuum cleaner.
I've no complaints.
The woman in reception described Nurse Grendel as a monster.
Well, that's simply not true. She's quite strict, but that's her job, isn't it? You've got to have discipline in a place like this.
No way. I'll come back later. What is it?
You haven't taken my blood pressure.
Seems fine to me.
You're not doing it right.
Of course I am.
No, you're not. Dr. Monroe never did it like that.
I can't take a satisfactory reading while you're excited like this. I'll come back later. Pardon me, nurse.
Oui, monsieur.
What is this device?
It's for taking the patient's blood pressure, doctor.
Can you show me how to do it?
Pardon me, nurse.
Oui, monsieur.
Do you want this,
device for measuring blood pressure?
Yeah, do you want it back?
No, thank you.
Thank you, nurse.
Au revoir, monsieur.
Oh,
what
you
okay.
They're supposed to do something.
You don't.
I'll come back when you. Hello.
Oh, now whistling, right?
Right. Are you having trouble with Mr. Shiny?
Yes, I am. I don't know what's got into him today. He keeps pulling his plug.
See
you later.
Yeah. Take care now.
Just not have anything to say about the pressure thingy? Oh, what? No, I don't.
Hi, my name's George Stobart.
Yes, sir? Pleased to meet you, sir.
Call me George if you like.
Are you sure?
Yeah, that's my name.
My name's Benoit, but everyone calls me Benny.
Bunny?
That's right. I used to have this cute habit when I was a kid.
Keep it to yourself, Benoit. Do you know the nurse on Ward J2?
No, monsieur. This is my first day here. I can't wait to get my hands dirty. I was talking about treating my first patient, of course. I didn't mean to get my hands dirty with the nurse.
Shut up, Benoit.
Okay, sir.
Do you know anything about a patient named Marquet?
No, sir, I don't know much about any of the patients.
I've never met a doctor who admits that he's only human.
I'm only a trainee, sir. I'm sure I'll get the hang of things.
Here, take this pressure gauge.
Thank you, sir. What do you want me to do with it?
Well, keep it safe until I think of something. See you later.
Right.
Excuse me, sir.
Aha! Just the man. You must be the new boy.
Yeah, I must be.
Well, stop wandering about and make yourself useful. Bernie, come here, boy. This is Benoit, my nephew. Can I trust you to look after him?
That's not how you're supposed to spell Benoit, but, you know.
It will open his eyes to see a real doctor on the job.
I'll bet.
Show him around. Let him see some real suffering.
All right. Oh, follow me, Benoit. But where are we, Benoit? What happened to you, Benoit? Benoit! Where did you go? Oh.
Excuse me.
No, never mind.
Thanks for your-
I guess if I just do this. And walk a little bit. Okay.
Hey, Benoit.
Yes, sir?
You still have that gauge I gave you?
Ah, yes. What do you want me to do with it?
Use it on Eric Sopmarsh.
Okay.
If you don't know how to do something, find someone to do it for you. Oh, I guess he's just doing it. Sweet.
I'm Dr. Stobart.
Bonjour, Doctor.
Have you heard of a guy called Marquet?
He's in quarantine, Doc, right behind this here door.
Marquet is just the man I wanted to see.
I wouldn't go in there if I was you. He has anthrax.
What?
I have to visit my patient.
What for?
Routine. I have to check he's still breathing.
What if he's not?
I'll sign the certificate and register his bed as vacant.
That's a cold and distant attitude to death.
Well, I've been institutionalized to the point of godlike aloofness.
The white coat suits you.
Thanks. Have you seen any suspicious characters on the ward?
Yeah, I have.
A gorilla and a weasel?
No, this was a tatty old bear.
How was the bear acting suspiciously?
Well, he was wearing a humbug.
Is that against the law?
No, but it's pretty weird for a bear.
Do you recognize the man in this photograph?
No, I have never seen him before.
Are you Thomas Merlin of Gruber Electronics?
No.
Then you won't be needing this. Would you like to shake hands?
What for?
As a gesture of goodwill.
On reflection? No.
Catch you later, officer.
Au revoir, Doc.
Marquet?
Yes. I am Marquet. I've been expecting you.
You have?
Well, what are you waiting for? Get it over with.
I just want to know what I should do with the gem.
The Lachmar gem?
Yeah, right here in my pocket.
I thought you were one of the...
Not me. I never inhaled.
So, you were sent in my place?
Yeah. You could hardly make the trip to Ireland in your condition. What should I do with the gem?
Deliver it to the Grand Master quickly. Tell him that I have found the tripod.
pot. Right here in Paris.
Will you have it?
Not yet. But it's being taken care of. I hired a couple of stooges with a flair for petty crime.
Would that be Flap and Guido by any chance?
You know them as for Klausner. He is gone off to Syria on a wild goose chase.
They have geese in Syria?
As a theory about the location of the...
That's enough excitement for one day, Monsieur Marquet. What are you doing here?
Talking to this patient, of course.
Monsieur Marquet is my patient. If Herr Hagenmeier was to hear that...
Okay, I'm going. I'd learned all I could from Marquet anyhow.
Ah, there you are, sir. I was just coming to look for you. I finished with your pressure gauge.
Thanks, Bunny.
What's that noise? It sounds as if someone's having a cardiac arrest.
It's all right. The doctor's in there with him.
Are you sure he was a doctor?
Oui, monsieur. He showed me his ID. It was Dr. Braille.
There's no Dr. Braille working here.
He's an imposter. The door's locked. Help me, officer.
Too late.
Come back, monsieur.
Do we really need to shoot the lock? Back in Nico's apartment.
Hello, George.
I found Jacques Marquet.
Did he talk?
Yeah, he talked. For the very last time.
He's dead?
Yeah. Killed in cold blood by a bogus doctor.
That's despicable. What kind of guy would pass himself off as a doctor and take advantage
of... What kind of guy, indeed?
I don't know who he was, but it certainly wasn't Khan. He got away out the window.
Oh, what's this icon?
Have you ever heard of the Hashi-Ashin?
No.
Marquet said that they were his biggest enemy.
His biggest enemy was the bogus doctor.
Don't remind me. That guy was evil. He had wild, staring eyes like a dead fish. I'll never trust a doctor again. Do you think the assassin was responsible for killing Marquet?
I don't think so. He could have finished him off the first time. Besides, Marquet would have recognized him.
He was pumped to the gills with sedatives. He wouldn't have recognized the four horsemen of the apocalypse unless they'd introduced themselves.
Okay.
I guess I'd better go back and talk to that weirdo.
Which one? Rousseau or Sergeant Mou? Oh, were you referring to André?
I'll let you work it out.
So we have finished the hospital, so let's try talking to Lobino. He's gonna receive. Okay, he's here.
I beg your pardon. Are you André Lobino?
That's me. You want my autograph?
No. I was told you...
Whoa, what a fucking hippie.
My name is George Stobart. I'd like your professional opinion.
Well, okay. Shoot.
Does the name Montfaucon mean anything to you?
Sure. It was the most grisly spectacle in Paris until the revolution.
A public toilet?
Montfaucon was the place of execution for many thousands. A dark temple of death with row upon row of arches, each one framing a grim exhibit. Scores of rotting corpses swung on creaking rope while the crows devoured their flesh.
That explains the image of the hanged man. I found a reference to Montfaucon in Ireland, in a village called Lochmarne.
Lochmarne? That's where Pegram was digging.
That's right. He'd left the excavation before I arrived. Do you know Pegram well?
Not really. I met him at a conference. I would have liked to talk to him in depth, but I didn't have time.
When was this?
Back in the summer, July, I think.
I think you ought to know that the tripod is going to be stolen.
The Lochman tripod? No.
It's true. I can give you a description of the thieves.
Before the supposed event has taken place?
I heard them planning the raid.
They're wasting their time. The tripod is protected by a state-of-the-art alarm system.
Well, don't say I didn't warn you. Have you ever heard of the Hashashin?
Why, yes. It was a radical Muslim sect whose name became synonymous with murder. It was formed in 11th century Persia, shortly before the Crusades.
At roughly the same time as the Templars.
Yes. They gave a new word to our language, Assassini. The Assassins.
Yeah, it makes you want to replay the original Assassins.
Why don't you loan the tripod to me for safekeeping?
Because I'd never see it again.
Well, don't you trust me?
It's not a question of trust, George. That tripod is hundreds of years old and extremely fragile.
I get your point. How did the Assassins get their name?
From the legend surrounding the secrets of their initiation rites. A young man who sought to join the sect was given hashish until he drifted into dreams. He awoke to find himself in a fabulous garden with everything he could wish for. The freshest water, the most delicious food, the choicest hash, and the most delectable women imaginable.
Cool. Do you have the address?
I haven't finished the story. There was a price to pay for this taste of paradise.
Wouldn't you just know it?
The young man would wake the next day to find himself back in the real world. He was told that he'd been given a glimpse of the heaven reserved for holy martyrs. A heaven he would enjoy for eternity if he was willing to join the Hashashin.
How did the Assassins operate?
Well, as I explained, the new recruits would be only too willing to die for the cause. They'd be instructed in the use of the dagger, poisons, and disguise. Then, the Grand Master of the sect would name an enemy of Allah.
And they'd stop at nothing to eliminate that enemy.
You got it. They were fearless and deadly.
Does the cult of the Assassin still exist?
Take a look around at the world today. You tell me.
Where was the site of Montfaucon?
To the northeast, near the Canal Saint-Martin, but there's nothing there now. The old gibbet was torn down during the Revolution.
I'd like your opinion on a medieval manuscript.
Vraiment? Do you have it with you?
No, it's too fragile. And besides, there are certain people who'd stop at nothing to get their hands on it.
Intriguing. Do you have a copy of the text?
There isn't much. Only a few Latin phrases. I was kind of hoping you'd help decipher the pictures.
Without seeing the manuscript, that's a tall order.
Just tell me one thing. What does the image of two men riding on the same horse suggest to you?
The Knights Templar. Does the Templar seal appear on this manuscript? I'd love to see that for myself.
The manuscript is being looked after by a friend.
In Paris?
Yeah. Not far from here, in fact.
Well, just give me the address and I'll come round and take a look.
I'm not so sure about that. Maybe I should check with her first.
A female friend?
Yeah, she's a woman. This friend who has the manuscript?
The anonymous girlfriend.
She lives at 361 Rue Jarry.
Ah, I know it well. I'll drop by just as soon as I can.
Can you tell me anything about the Knights Templar?
I sure can, Georgie. Soldiers,
Georgie.
Mercenaries, monks, bankers, you name it, the Templars fit the bill. The greatest fighting force in Christendom, the militia of Christ.
Jeez. How did the Templars get their name?
From the building in which they set up their headquarters. The King of Jerusalem gave them part of a mosque on the Temple Mount. It was said to have been the site of the original Temple of Solomon. The order became known first as the Knights of the Temple, and later as the Knights Templar.
You're a mine of information, Andre.
Glad to be of help, Georgie.
How come the Templars became so wealthy?
There was a constant stream of new recruits to their ranks, many from noble families. They were required to swear a sacred oath of poverty, chastity, and obedience. So, their money, goods, and lands were donated to the order. The Templars soon held land in France, Scotland, England, Spain, most of Europe, in fact. The poor Knights of Christ became the wealthiest power in Christendom.
Is it true the treasure of the Knights Templar was never found?
Who knows? So little knowledge of what really happened remains. Or if it does, the truth has never been made public.
What do you mean by that?
The Templars have attained a mythological status, like the King Arthur of the Britons. There are people even now who say the Templars still exist.
Do you think that's likely?
No, not for a minute.
Does the guy in this photograph look familiar to you?
No.
All right, well, then that's probably it. Thank you, Andre.
You're welcome.
Attention! Please do not open the window, monsieur.
Don't you think it's kind of stuffy in here?
Better stuffy than dead.
What's the problem? Fumes from car exhausts?
Not just that, monsieur. There's a new burger bar opened up across the street. The Laughing Buffalo.
So what's the problem?
They cook their burgers on a charcoal grill. And the fat falls on the open flames. The amount of organic compound and smoke particles released is astounding. Since they opened, local air pollution has doubled. And it stinks like a funeral pyre. That is why I keep the windows closed.
Okay.
The case contained the tripod shown on the manuscript.
I just need to wait until he's turned. All right. All right.
It is closing time, Monsieur Lobineau.
Already, there just aren't enough hours in the day.
More than enough for me. I can't wait to get home and put my feet up.
Eh bien, see you tomorrow.
Good night, monsieur.
Why did I do that? Again, that's where having played this game before is an advantage.
Get your ass over here and bring that flashlight.
Come on here!
What the? Who's there?
Let's get out of here!
That honestly makes no goddamn sense.
And when I woke up, I was at the police station. Luckily, I managed to persuade Rosso I was innocent.
Poor George.
What a mess. I bungled the whole thing.
I don't think so. You made a pretty good job of distracting those two crooks.
Yeah, but the killer got away with the tripod.
No, he didn't. He's not the only one who can dress up in costume.
You mean it was you who stole the tripod? Oh, hell, Nico. I could have been shot.
Those dogs are more likely to shoot their own feet.
I just wish you'd told me your plans. We're supposed to be in this together. And how come you dressed up like a pantomime cat?
Don't silk Georgie, please.
Oh, rats. And don't call me Georgie.
Oh, I really thought you'd be pleased. After all, we've got the tripod.
We need to talk about the fact that she just, I don't know, went down a rope, dropped kicked a, like, gangster, stole the tripod and left? Like, is that part of a journalist training, really?
Oh, by the way, I had a visit from Andre Lobino.
Oh, yeah. I hope you didn't mind me giving him your address.
Not at all. It was lovely to see him again. He was over the moon when I showed him the manuscript. It's not often he gets that excited. He made a sketch of the Knight's Crest to take back to the museum. I believe he's identified the family who bear that crest.
I sure hope so.
Okay.
I'd better get back to the quest.
Now that we have everything, we can look at Malfonso.
Excuse me, officer. What do you know about the Knights Templar?
Les Templiers. Only that they were excommunicated in 1312 and hanged in their dozens within this very square.
Boy, what they teach in the police academy these days.
No, monsieur. I read it on that board over there.
Shouldn't you be off directing traffic or something?
You have seen the Parisian traffic, no?
Yeah, so?
I could direct the traffic, the most dangerous, the east side of Rome. Or I can sit here and enjoy the sun, the architecture, and the so-so Sauvignon. Which would you choose?
Yeah, but I'm not a policeman. What happened to duty?
An excellent question, monsieur.
Have you seen this man before?
No. Who is it?
I believe him to be an international assassin.
Oh.
Is that all you can say? Oh.
I did wonder if I should say that I believe you to be an international paranoiac, but it didn't seem polite.
I don't want to talk to him about anything else.
Oui, monsieur. I'll be there.
What do we have? Find you. Actually, this guy.
Excuse me, father.
Pardon?
Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all, monsieur. It will be my pleasure to help you.
What do you know about the Knights Templar?
You have come to the right place, if that is your interest. Many of them were executed in the square outside. It was a disgrace to France.
Well, the Pope was right behind it, though.
Clement V was a man of mammon, not of God.
That's kind of forthright for a priest, isn't it?
You think so? It is hard to be sure what happened. It is so long ago.
How long have you worked here?
Hardly work, monsieur. This is a calling. I have been helping Father Flambert for nearly 6 months now.
I guess you don't know much about the history of this church, then.
Just a little.
You've got quite a shine on that candlestick.
Ah, oui. Anything less than best would be an insult to the Almighty.
I guess so. I never thought of it like that. I've got a medieval tripod. How about this for a gem?
It is very beautiful, monsieur. And yet, I feel that there is an air of suffering about it.
Catch you later.
Au revoir.
What else can we do?
A knight, there in the company of his fellows. Biblical references engraved into the tomb edge to guide his way to the next world. I guess. A statue of a knight holding a staff and a scroll. The statue had any secrets. It was concealing them pretty well. A scroll was a symbol of scholarship. I knew that much. A scholarly knight. That rang a bell. A very Spanish bell. On the end of the staff was some kind of disc with a cross on it. Around the base of the disc was a hairline crack. A statue of a knight holding a staff and a scroll. The statue had an A stone knight lay in full stone armor, blank eyes looking at the ceiling. Carrying all that armor around must have been hard work.
That's him again. See, Mark Sander explored Churchill.
Hello again, Father.
Bonjour, Monsieur. How pleasant to speak to you again.
No, I guess not, huh?
What do you think of this?
A precious sleeve and valve? What should I think?
Never mind. Have you seen this man before?
No, I have never seen him before.
I've got a red nose.
Oui, so you have.
That is very...
There's grease paint on this tissue.
Oui, you are correct.
Like, let's just say yes to this guy.
I thought about using this, but I couldn't do that to a priest. Catch you later.
Au revoir, monsieur.
Like, I have to do something to the statue, but I'm not quite sure what just yet.
A row of old pews, beautifully carved and glowing with polish. I thought of all the people who must have sat here over the decades. All those Parisian derrières, firm buttocks of the young ladies, the flabby flesh of the old men. That wasn't a pleasing image, so I went back to the young ladies.
Sure.
Whoa!
Oh, you really went to the young ladies, huh?
Hey, you with the balls.
Oui?
How did you learn to be a juggler?
Juggler? What is this juggler?
It's you. You juggle, that makes you a juggler.
No, I am a jongleur.
A jongleur?
Typical French.
Mon Dieu. A jongleur is an artist. A master of the contra-gravitic aerobaletic mysteries. In centuries past, the courts of the crowneds of Europe and the jongleurs. Witty, erudite men to whom the monarchs turned in their hours of need.
Wait a minute, wait. Let me get this straight. Our enemies are at the borders. Plague ravages the land, and the peasants are revolting. Thank God we've got Chuckles the Jongler to throw his balls around. I don't think so. That juggling doesn't look so difficult.
Oh, it does not, does it not? Perhaps you feel you could do better. No?
I'll give it a try.
Be my guest.
I had no idea what I was doing. But this guy was obviously an idiot, so how difficult could it be? A lot more difficult than I thought. That's how difficult. Still, it was my big chance to be derided by complete strangers.
Not so easy after all, is it?
No, I guess not.
See, but what you gotta do, take advantage of it.
Hi again.
Oui? What is it this time?
Look, a red nose.
Ah, you are a clown.
A clown?
No, if so, you would be a much better jongleur.
For a moment, an idea capered around near the spotlight of my attention, but fell down the pothole of abstraction before I could focus on it. What do you know about the Knights Templar?
Le Templier? Ah, their last Grand Master, Jacques Dumollet, was burned on an island in the Seine in 1314.
Wow. You're pretty well educated for a juggler.
No, monsieur. I read it on that board over there.
Catch you later.
Au revoir, monsieur.
Hello again.
Hello again, monsieur.
See you around.
I had no desire to.
Oh.
I couldn't open it with my bare hands. In the middle of the square was a manhole. I wondered if there might be something relevant beneath street level.
Hey, you! What do you think you are doing? Leave that camera alone, now.
Sorry, no harm intended.
You stay away from that.
Hi again.
Oui?
Look.
Ah!
A clap.
No.
For a moment, but fell down the... Catch you.
It's like, I know what I want to do. At least I know what the ultimate result is. I don't want to juggle with the red nose on.
What do you know about mid... Have a look at this little baby.
A tripod. What is it for?
You mean you don't know?
No, monsieur. Nor do you, I think.
Do you know what this is?
It's a sewer key.
Take a look at this.
Ah, an electrician.
I'll see you around.
Oui, monsieur. I'll be there.
No, I want to try and use myself.
Hi again.
Oui? What is it this time?
Look, ah!
No.
For a moment, but felt... This gadget is a sewer key.
I do not want it. Thank you.
Well, I'm not selling it. I just wanted your opinion.
It is hardly my area of expertise.
Have you seen this man before?
No.
I've got a medieval tripod.
And my Uncle Claude has hemorrhoids. So what?
Wow. I mean, you know, it was a weird thing to talk about, but still.
Does this interest you?
Well,
forget it. Forget that I asked. Does this grease paint mean anything to you?
A red nose? And now? Grease paint? You are sure you are not a clown?
Well, I was distracted by the idea again. Caper, caper, caper. Plummet. No. Gone again. It didn't seem right to fry somebody's palm when they make their living with their hands. Does this matchbook mean anything to you?
You smoke?
No, I don't.
In that case, it means nothing to me.
Does this lab pass mean anything to you?
You work in a lab.
No, try again.
You steal lab passes?
No. Well, not as a habit. This was a special case. What do you think of this?
It is a medical device, oui?
Feast your eyes on this.
Incroyable! Is it real?
I think so.
Some people believe that great gems always have curses upon them.
Oh, that's garbage. Although, now that I think about it, both of the people who had this before me disappeared in mysterious circumstances. And the guy who was supposed to get this was shot and then murdered in his hospital bed. Do you want it?
No!
Catch you later.
What is?
There was a small crowd of 5 sightseers. It's a weird thing, but you can take the most intelligent people in the world, put them in their vacation duds, and hey presto, they look like morons. Why is that?
Can I use the grease paint on myself?
In the middle of the I wondered. Hi again.
We. How do I ask you? I want a hint. Okay. Apparently, I had to shoot this guy a clown nose.
Does this red nose mean anything to you?
Ah, you are a clown.
Do I look like a clown?
No. Although you juggle like one. Now, if I'd known.
That's why he had to say that.
Amusing and not a humiliation for you.
What do you mean?
Who ever heard of a plainclothes clown?
He had a point. So you're saying that if I juggle badly with a red nose, I'd be the king of comedy. But if I juggle badly without it.
You look like a pathetic loon. Oui, monsieur, you have it.
I'll see you.
All right, that should do it.
Hi again.
Oui? What is it this time?
I'd like to have another try at juggling, please.
You have gone on a crash course, perhaps?
No. I just had an insight into presentation.
Huh?
Allow me to demonstrate. The balls, please.
If you insist on completing your humiliation, monsieur.
Okay, now for my secret weapon.
It's funny that they couldn't even draw Sprite with the nose on.
Could have mistaken him for a mime. And without a word, he collected his balls and left in a fury.
Hey, you missed one.
Hey, you forgot one of your balls. Hey,
you forgot your ball, man.
Still, deprived of his entertainment, the gendarme decided maybe he ought to do some policing for a change.
Man, being a Paris gendarme sounds like the sweet life.
In French, English, and German, it read, in 1312, Pope Clement V dissolved the Knightly Order of the Templars and excommunicated its members on charges of heresy. In the following 2 years, many of the knights were hanged on this site. Their Grand Master, Jacques de Molay, was burnt at the stake on an island in the Seine.
All right. Then everybody's gone. Excuse me. Thank you. What do we have?
A weird little boat lay tied up. I guess they used it to get maintenance crews around. Either on the boat was a winching machine. The wall had flaked, and anything once written on it had long since gone.
Okay, what about this one?
The inscription was hard to read, but I made out Templier and something about innocence. There were three arches, each with an inscription. My medieval French isn't much. But the few words I understood seemed to say, this is where the gallows used to stand. Maybe. The hook lay in a bed of chain. The inscription was hard to read.
Oh, you know what? Maybe I just need to. Am I gonna be able to wipe it? No. Yeah, okay. Let's see what's on this side. Oh, jeez. This looks creepy.
I pushed against the door, but it seemed to be locked. The door was a handsome piece of work. On the boat. The inscription was hard to read, but I made out Templier and something about innocence.
We've looked at every hot spot.
If I wanted to get deeper into these catacombs, I was going to have to get onto that path. If the near edge hadn't crumbled away, I could have jumped it easily.
You know, let's go back and talk to the priests. You touch me.
Hello again, Father.
Bonjour, monsieur. How pleasant to speak to you again.
You must be proud to have such an incredible collection of stained glass.
Pride is a sin, monsieur. But it is hard not to marvel when the light shines through them. It is a fine example of the artisan's genius.
Catch you later.
Oh.
Well, I could have just taken the end off the staff. But I wanted to be sure what I'd be getting out of vandalizing a church, other than deported. A stone knight lay at the end of a row of four. I wondered if this guy had died in combat.
You guys just still looking at nothing.
On the boat. There, in the middle of the door, I could see some kind of socket.
Gem? I gotta do something with that, but what? What? Oh, the good sound is because I've been just trying random shit, I guess.
If I wanted to get deeper into these catacombs, I was going to have to get onto that path. If the near edge hadn't crumbled away, I could have jumped it easily.
Alright, I am stuck at the moment, so I guess this is a good spot for us to save and quit. What's up with these? Time must wash away the sadness and let it dissolve in faith. Bring, bring. It always helps. What the fuck is this? I have no idea. In any case, yeah, we're gonna pick this up tomorrow. I don't wanna just use the hint yet. I'm gonna try and roam around and talk to people and try a bunch of things. And if we get stuck tomorrow at some point, we'll just go ahead and go for it. But in the meantime, thank you for watching. You can find me at twitch.tv/gameswithnick and youtube.com/gameswithnick. Nick spelled N-I-C. Yeah, I'll be back tomorrow with a little bit more of Broken Sword. Probably not a lot, but a little bit more. So thank you for watching, and until next time.